All right, we are live. I haven't said that in a long time. But yeah, we are definitely live.
Hi, John.
How are you doing? All right, so let's make sure we are live.
Let's make sure we are live.
All right, so we, well, I know we live on Facebook because I can see it's people already watching. So we're live on Facebook. Are we live on YouTube? Let me make sure. And we are live on YouTube also.
Okay.
So we're live on Facebook. We're live on YouTube. Yeah, we're live on Facebook, we're live on YouTube. And my other computer is moving slow all of a sudden. All right, so let me show you a comment the way I make it pop up on screen. Matter of fact, for everybody that's watching this on Facebook, thank you.
Hi, people.
You guys should be able. The thing about me streaming on Facebook and YouTube is people can actually read the captions. There's captions on the video. But let me do it. Let me show you a example of the way that the comments will pop up on the screen when somebody comments. So in the comment section on Facebook, I just added a comment. Now, can you see that comment that I added?
No.
All right. Now, if you look on the screen, do you see that?
Yeah. No, I see.
Do you see it? You don't see it?
Oh. Instagram.com is Yasmin. That?
All right. So are you holding your phone? This is my phone. This is my phone case. Are you holding your phone this way or that way? This way?
Has to be like this?
No, it don't matter how it is. I'm trying to figure out how you can actually see the comments. I'm surprised you can't see the comments.
I can't.
Do you see the comments on the screen?
No,
I don't see
comments.
Yeah, so I think what I'm gonna have to do is I don't know if you guys can actually go this way. Like right now, my camera is held this way; it's not held this way. But I want to say
I have to switch.
Yeah, rotate it. Okay, so now. Okay, so now do you see my comment?
Honestly,
do
you see it? Your comment? No, I just see www.instagram.com, Miss Yasmin.
Okay, so I have no idea how I can get you to see the comment. Now, somebody did comment on it, and they said to have you use a second device, which is what I was telling you before.
I'm using.
If you click into the live from your second device, you should be able to watch the live.
I have it.
Yeah. So do you see those two comments now?
Yes.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Oh yeah. When you watch it from the other device, you got to mute it.
So yeah.
Mute the other device and just
it's mute.
You'll just be able to watch it back. Yeah, that was Jessica Smith. She was saying to have her watch it from another device.
Yes.
So I haven't been live in a long time because I've been doing a lot of private one-on-ones. But this is where my intro comes in. Matter of fact, let me get some water because it's hot.
Yeah, I can see now. Yes. Oh yeah, I can see the comments. Hafer uses even device like a computer.
All right, y'all, I'm back.
Okay.
All right, so let me get settled so I can do. This is the thing about going live is a lot of getting together.
I see.
All right, so let's make sure YouTube is still good. All right, so YouTube is good.
All right, y'all, I'm back.
All right, so hi, how's everyone doing? My name is John. I am the host of EVON TV. I'm also the creator of EVON Magazine, EVON Bold Magazine. I got six magazines. I just don't want to name all of them. And I am the leader, because I hate to say owner, of EVON Models. And my guest tonight is Yasmina, right?
Hello.
Now, you know, I was telling you that the comment section usually controls the conversation. You know, I've been live enough times so everybody knows to keep things modeling related. Now, I do have a whole lot of comments. So what I'm going to do is bring these comments on the screen whenever they pop up on my end, and it's taking forever to pop up. But that's why I hate going YouTube live.
I see comments.
Yeah, so we have Tihara King, who asked you, asked, where are you from?
So I'm from Spain. I was born in Madrid, and I grew up in Ibiza. It's an island in Spain.
Are you signed to anyone?
Excuse me?
Are you signed? Are you a freelance model or are you signed?
I'm freelance.
You freelance?
For now.
And you are in New York, correct?
Yes, I live in New York, in Brooklyn.
Give me one second. Live 101 interview. I got somebody that just wrote me and asked me, how can they watch this on YouTube? But yeah, so how tall are you?
I'm let me think, because I know in centimeters, 170 is 5'7", I think.
5'7"?
Yes, 5'7".
Now, I don't know if this is a bad thing, but how old are you?
It's, yes, 5'7".
How old are you?
How old I am?
If you don't want to say, don't say.
I don't want to say.
Yeah, because I know.
Let's leave the people think.
I know. People tell me don't ask a model or don't ask a woman how old she is. But then I'd be like, hey, she might be like 40, but she looked 20. You know,
hey, so, you are close.
Yeah. So, how long have you been modeling?
So not too much, like 5 months, 6 months, something like this.
You've been modeling 6 months?
But you know, with all this situation, the pandemic and all this, everything was like in pause. So now is when it's starting to run again.
Yeah, I want everybody to know that we did not pre-have this conversation. So if I act like I'm surprised, it's because I'm really am surprised. I didn't know you was modeling 6 months.
I just want to say something.
Yeah.
Just sorry for my English, because it's not perfect, but I can have a conversation, okay? For the people that I hope they can understand what I say.
Yeah, you're good. You're good. So thank you for everybody that's watching on YouTube. But
yes, thank you to everyone.
Oh, speaking of that, so I always tell people this because I know people always ask me. If you see me looking off, like looking right here, I have another computer right there.
Okay.
So this computer right here is controlling everything that's on this computer right here. So when somebody comments, if I look over, it's because I have to be able to read the comment. I know people always ask me who am I looking at?
That your eyes are like this.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm looking at another computer. I haven't figured out yet how to get all this stuff in one big setup. So
okay.
I'm looking on another computer. So what I'm about to do is I'm about to pop your Instagram up on the screen. And I'm gonna stroll through your Instagram and let people see. Speaking of that, her Instagram is in the caption of the video, so feel free to follow. All right, give me 1 second. All right, so let's see how this is going to work. Speaking of that, while I get this set up, what's your goals with modeling? Like, what's your ultimate goal?
So my goal is work like a model and travel over the world.
Travel around the world with it? With modeling?
For modeling. That will happen soon. That's my idea.
All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take us both out of the screen. And I am going to pop your Instagram up onto the stream. Matter of fact, I'm going to take myself out, and I'm going to pop up the Instagram. Hold on. All right, so let me switch these sides. And all right, so for those that was watching, that's a quick look at her Instagram. Feel free to follow her on Instagram.
Miss Yasmin.
Now, how do you pronounce your last name?
Oh, my last name is Obono. O-B-O-N-O, Obono.
Obono?
Obono.
So, I wrote you on Instagram and I asked you if you wanted to do a live, right? Now, I forgot how I came across you on Instagram. I forgot how. But I do remember the first photo that I saw.
Which one?
I am about to show you and go to my DMs, and then I'm gonna tell you.
Mm-hmm.
You had a photo on that was shot by almost like fish eye. It was mm-hmm. It's a yellow long sleeve shirt.
Mm-hmm.
You know what photo I'm talking about?
I know.
Yeah. So I had a photographer on Instagram. Send me a DM with that photo. Because the thing by me having a magazine, I talked to a lot of photographers, right? So a lot of times these photographers, I think they're trying to introduce me to new models.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how I first came across you. Then I followed you. And then it was like, usually I do this thing on Instagram where I just watch somebody. I don't say anything. I just like photos. And I just watch. Right.
So give me a moment. You say that this photographer sent to you a
message,
my picture.
Yeah, a photographer sent me your photo because I made a post about looking for models.
Mm-hmm.
I said originally I said Baltimore. Mm-hmm. I was looking for models in Baltimore.
Mm-hmm.
Cause another photographer hit me up and he asked me, "Can I help?" He was traveling. He was traveling to the east side and he was asked, or to the east coast. And he was asking me, can I help him find models?
Mm-hmm.
Now, I think in your bio, it says New York. I know Baltimore and New York, it's not too far. It's not too far away, right?
No, it's not.
Yeah, so he sent me the photo. And that's when I actually seen in your in a caption of your bio that you was from New York.
Mm-hmm.
So all I did was just follow.
I remember.
And then I see you make a post or a picture, and then I commented on it. Do you want to do a live chat or a live interview? So, because I always tell people, you never know who's watching. So yeah. It's like, by me being a magazine owner, and a lot of people don't know who I am,
mm-hmm.
I'm able to just watch.
Mm-hmm.
Cause I like to be aware of who's out there, just in case I end up coming to Baltimore, or I end up coming to New York, or I end up coming to Florida. I like to know who's out there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so you know how like you can save people photos on Instagram. I was supposed to be in Atlanta. I'm supposed to be in New York, or not Atlanta and Florida. So I have models in a list of when it's time for me to come to Florida or Atlanta for me to hit up.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that was when I first came across your Instagram. Now, how did you get into modeling?
So I came to New York 3.5 years ago, and I started to work like a dancer, bachata dancer, like Latin music. And later, after a year, I decided to work in another staff. And after another year, I decided to work in the industry. So mm-hmm. yeah, since I was little, I always wanted to be a model, dancer, all that world. So because of that, I came to New York from far away. I didn't speak even any English. Yeah, the beginning was hard, but now it's getting better after 3 years.
Are you, or do you get paid for your modeling?
Mm-hmm, yeah, I'm starting to get paid.
So you've been modeling for 6 months and you already...
6 months, but you know that some of those months doesn't count because everything was...
Oh, because everything was shut down?
Yeah, so now is when I'm trying to, you know, to work hard.
Do you have you... What am I trying to ask? Have you applied to any agencies?
Yeah, I'm about to be signed for an agency with Bella Davis.
They're in New York?
In New York, LA, London, Cape Town.
Oh, Cape Town? Yeah.
Yeah, Cape Town, Miami. Yes. I'm on my way.
Now, do you know what kind of modeling you do? I should have put that in the caption of this stream. Mm-hmm. But do you know what type of modeling you do?
I don't want to do fashion, but I feel very comfortable with lingerie, swimsuit. But I'm open to work in great projects, you know, with people that they have good ideas, creativity. I love that.
Yeah, you sent me a photo. No, you didn't send it to me. I shared it on my page where you was in all white. What's his name? I think it's Marin Photo, New York, NYC.
Oh, yes.
He's one of the best photographers from New York that I've seen.
You know him?
I don't know him, but I like we follow each other.
Oh yes.
So yeah, he's one of the best guys from New York that I have literally seen.
I know. He's amazing. His name is Ruben, and I almost have photo shoots with him every Monday. And because the idea is to be featured in a magazine. So yeah. We are working on that.
Yeah, he shoots a lot of stuff for Elements Magazine.
Mm-hmm.
And Elements, if I'm correct, Elements is from New York, and Elements is like the largest independent magazine that there is, at least on Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
Elements is a big deal, and I know he shoots for them a lot.
Yeah, no, he's great. Seriously, his work is. I have other photographers too. Paul Tirado is very good. You know him?
What's his name?
Paul Tirado.
Have you shot with him already?
Oh, I was working with him just one time, but he recommended me to Bella Davis. So later, yeah. She contacted me for the agency. Another one, EJ Creative, too. One of my favorites, too. I have to say.
Yeah. I have to get to New York. I've been in New York one time, but when I went, it wasn't for modeling. At all, it's from when I used to do music. I used to be a music artist, but I haven't been in New York for modeling at all. So mm-hmm. I'm hoping that my magazine is the reason for why I get to go to New York. That's so it's like I'm building up my magazine to be to a point where I could literally travel the world, but I have to get to New York because of my magazine.
Of course, you know that this is the center.
Yeah, New York is everything.
It's everything. It's nonstop. There is always something to do. There are always projects. People, it's a different energy. People are really connected with themselves about what they want to do, what they already are, and yeah. Sometimes can be a little bit too much,
mm-hmm.
but we really need this speed and be awake, you know, and do stuff and just, yeah.
So for everyone that's watching this, for anybody who wants to comment and their comment actually shows up in the stream, you have to watch it from either her page mm-hmm. or mine. So for everybody that's watching this from one of my group pages on Facebook, when you comment, I mean, I can read it, but I want her to be able to also be able to see it. So If you can, click into her page or my page, and leave the comment there so that I don't have to be jumping back and forth in between my groups. Let me make this comment. Let them know. I'm gonna send them the link to the live.
Yeah, you can go to my Facebook, Yasmina Obono, and I will add you so you can see the interview.
Do you do a lot of shoots? Like, do you shoot often?
Non-stop, yes.
Non-stop?
I try to do as much as I can because the thing is that there are a lot of photographers that they just contact me through Instagram.
Yeah.
We just shoot. Because those are really great opportunities, you know. Later I can have material in my profile, and yeah, we can work together.
Do you have a website? You have a website?
A website?
Yeah.
No, not yet.
All right, give me one second. Jessica Smith says she loves New York, except for the snow. Matter of fact, yeah. Jessica's from Wisconsin. We got snow here.
I hate the snow. No, I like the snow, but I hate the cold here.
Seriously. I think it's, like, for people that stay in New York, it's hard to, like, how do they have Christmas with no snow?
I know. But it's like, not even just about the snow. It's about the cold.
It's the cold? Yeah.
It's too cold. Imagine, look, I don't have almost, you know, not too much body. So, yeah, I'm always cold here. It's what I don't like. And the summer is too hot for me. September, May are like the best months here.
Yeah, it's, I couldn't stay in a world where it's hot all the time.
How is Wisconsin? I don't even know where is Wisconsin.
So I remember
being in Spain and just watching films and here, Wisconsin. But
yeah, Wisconsin. We're in the Midwest, so we get snow. We get all four seasons. The thing about Wisconsin, the thing about the Midwest that I like the most is that we don't get those natural disasters. So we don't get the earthquakes. We don't get the heat waves. We don't get the
hurricane,
the floods, the hurricanes, tornadoes. Okay. We don't get natural disasters. We get the regular super cold blizzards, hot. You know, luckily we don't get what people down south and on the west coast get. But we get all four seasons. Usually our winters are cold, and our summers are hot. It's not as hot as LA, but we get comfortable hot. You know, we don't get 100 degree weather. We probably get like 80. Very rarely we'll get 90s.
But that's good because it's not crazy. It's not too much. But I have to say, if I'm honest, I just love the sun because I grew up in an island and I can be in the sun forever, 24/7.
How long have you been how long have you been living in New York?
Yeah, 3.5 years, yeah.
3 years?
I was living in, when I came here, Bronx, I was not too much time because I didn't like. Later, I was living in Queens, I was living in Manhattan. Now I live in Brooklyn. Definitely, I love Brooklyn. And Manhattan, but Manhattan is too expensive. You know how
you're in Brooklyn, New York.
Yes, I live close to Williamsburg. It's a good area because there are a lot of artists and yeah, a lot of people that you can do good, interesting stuff, work together.
Have you ever done a fashion show?
Sorry?
Have you ever done a fashion show?
Oh, no, not yet. Here in New York, no.
Is this something that you would want to do?
Oh yes, I wanted to go to the fashion week.
Yeah,
two fashion weeks. I think now in October or November.
Yeah, so fashion week is back. Like fashion week is coming back.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I know. I heard they doing. A lot of fashion shows have been canceled, and people are doing virtual fashion shows.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So they're doing their shows online.
Oh, online? Okay. Yeah, you have to look for a solution.
Yeah, because COVID is changing a lot of stuff. People got to adapt. We got to adapt to it.
Now everything will be online. So
yeah,
if you don't know about computers or about internet, about phone, you should.
Yeah, everything is online. Everything is going online.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know even agencies closed. So it's like there's no more open calls. So people got to literally submit an email their photos and comp cards, and there's no open calls anymore.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know. Yeah, but there is always something there. It's about to have connections and stay aware about what is happening, you know. There is always some show or fashion show.
All right, so for someone that's, because I didn't know you only been modeling for less than a year. Do you have any advice for
mm-hmm.
a new model?
Yes. So I think that the most powerful advice is just be yourself. Don't compete because I don't really believe in competition. I believe in just give the best of yourself, you know? So like that, you won't have competition. You just focus on yourself. You are not trying to compare your, you know, because everything is about, you always try to compare the body of the one girl with yours, and you want this and in this world is, sometimes you can feel sad, you can feel that you are not enough, but it's not like that. Because a girl can be beautiful, but later if the personality sucks, if it's not good, so doesn't matter.
Yeah, personality is important.
Yes, it is, of course. So just that, just be yourself and really trust in who you are and what do you want to do, and just go straight.
Have you had any issues, like complications, problems, being so new to modeling?
Oh, so yeah, I had a lot because I'm not from here.
Yeah.
So it's not easy how I told you before, but it's okay. You just have to overcome the fears, overcome the situations that are, you know, difficult, but it's okay. Everything will be good. I'm really focusing in my career like a model and as a model, and I know I will do great.
Are you modeling for anybody, like any brands or anything?
Not right now, but everything is in, a lot of projects are coming.
Yeah, everything, mm-hmm. everything is in the works.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes, it's, I can tell you that I have projects nonstop. Always people are contacting me through Instagram. And I have few things that I'm already doing. I was recording an episode 2 for a series for YouTube. And mm-hmm. I'm on my way to be an actress too, you know, acting, modeling, everything.
Oh, so you act also?
Mm-hmm. Yes. The only issue is the English, but I'm working on that too. More than the English, the accent, because for me it's very difficult.
Not the English. It's the accent.
Exactly. Yeah. Because how you can see and hear, I have a lot of accent. But it's okay. We can understand each other.
Are you trying to be more of a model or more of an actor?
I don't think that you can do only one thing in life.
They're kind of together.
Yeah, because everything is in the same world. So I want to be a model, I want to be an actress, and I want to be a dancer. Everything. At least know a little bit of everything, you know? So I can work like as an actress, as a model, and as a dancer too. Sometimes as an actress, they need a person that knows how to dance too for some play, you know? So always that helps.
You don't have any tattoos, do you?
Yes.
You do?
Mm-hmm. I have one here. No, here. I have one here.
Oh, there's one there. Yeah, they're not. They're not.
They are small and how can I say, sexy, like not too big, you know, something beautiful.
Do you travel?
Sorry?
Do you travel?
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. I travel. Not right now, but I travel.
Well, one thing I can say is if you ever end up traveling to the Midwest for modeling, Chicago is like the biggest. I believe Chicago is the largest modeling market in the Midwest.
Okay,
they have all the big agencies there. So in the Midwest, they're the largest modeling market. They have Ford, they got Wilhelmina there, they got all the big guys in Chicago. If there's anybody from Chicago that's watching this, feel free to comment.
People from Chicago. I would go to Chicago for sure.
But I can tell you, if you come in the wintertime, it might be snow.
Yeah,
after it might be a lot of snow.
Chicago.
Mm-hmm. I wouldn't be surprised.
Visit LA too.
Yeah, LA is good too.
Mm-hmm. I have never been in California. I really want to go.
You ever been to Florida or Texas?
Yes, Florida. During the quarantine, I was in
quarantine, yeah.
Like for three, four months.
Were you stuck there or you were just down there?
So I have a friend from Spain. She lives here in Manhattan.
Mm-hmm.
And she told me, come with me because my boyfriend, his family lives in Florida. So let's go there because New York will be crazy in these months. And yeah, New York was crazy in March, April was, yeah, too much. So yeah, there was better. Always when it's the sun, it's much better.
Yeah, we have a photographer from my city named Jessica Smith. She said when she went to LA, a lot of the models that she met was also into acting. They were doing a lot more commercial work.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, I think LA is known. Well, LA got Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
So they're known for the actors and acting in the movies.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have an application that the name is Backstage. I don't know if you hear about that.
So, that's the name of it?
So on Backstage,
they
post a lot of works, a lot of jobs for an actress, you know, model, commercials. So there I have a lot of jobs that they are already paid.
Yeah, you're talking about backstage.com.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. So Backstage, hold on. Okay, so I know what backstage.com is. Backstage.com is for people who are into acting and voiceovers and webinars and auditions where you can actually be discovered. Like you put yourself out there.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, can I put that in the... I'm going to tag that. Everybody that's on YouTube watching is BACKSTAGE.com. Backstage.com.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a great application. There are a lot of jobs. It's good.
Everyone that's watching on YouTube, thank you. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.
Matter of fact, if you're watching this on YouTube, go ahead and share this. Speaking of that, I need to put her Instagram in the caption. Everybody that's on YouTube right now watching this, give me about 10 seconds and her Instagram will be in the description of this live. So it's there right now. And somebody just
follow me.
Follow her on Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. So for everybody that's watching this on YouTube, her Instagram handle is clickable in the description of the live. All right, so I like to know models. What is the word for it?
What is what?
I like to know models, pros and cons of modeling, right? Because I think everything has pros and cons when it comes to stuff that we enjoy doing. Is it anything in modeling that you feel like is a con? Like something that, like an issue? Any bad experiences?
Yeah, maybe with photographers sometimes when they are not too professionals, or when I will talk in general, maybe models too, you know, about the ego, when they think that they are better because they are shooting you, you know, when I think it's 50-50, no? Without me, you can't shoot, and without you, I can't, you know, have my pictures.
Right.
So, yeah, sometimes it's, like, good to just go down your ego and try to communicate and understand the other person, and like that we will have a great job, you know? Great work, great pictures, great energy, and everything will look very organic. Just that, yeah, sometimes, or maybe someone that wants to touch more than and I have to. but no. In general, it's everything good. And I have to say that normally when I have a photo shoot with a photographer, normally I have more than one with them.
Yeah.
So that's great because you build a relation, and there is a moment that in the photo shoots, you just understand each other so good that everything just go
super. Everything is smooth. Yeah, yes. Everything is smooth and easy.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think. Why can I not think of the words I want to use today?
Mm-hmm.
Usually I know exactly what words I want to use, but some parent all day today I've been lost with the exact words I want to use. Mm-hmm. But I think the thing with the photographers, is that the only bad thing? Like you haven't had any issues when it comes to designers or makeup artists or anything like that?
No, not really. No. You know, all of us, we are from a different parents, different mother, different father. So we are different. And how I told you before, is about the communicate and just feel the other person too. It's not only you. To be a team. So when you know that, everything is organic. But no, I didn't have like an experience with, no, not yet. I have to say that in Spain, I was working like a model too, but like for maybe for a brand, you know, like in doing runway at the beach in Ibiza,
yeah.
This island, I was working. But here is when I'm doing it more serious and really focused on that.
So,
I mean, that is not that I just started 6 months ago. No, I did before.
Yeah, so you were modeling before you came over?
Yes.
To the States?
Mm-hmm.
Now, I know this is going to sound funny, right? But I have no idea where is Spain. Where is Spain at?
What?
Where is Spain?
Where is Spain?
Where, yeah.
Oh, where is Spain? In Europe.
It's in Europe.
So, you know Africa?
Yeah.
Africa, Spain is up. Very close to Morocco.
Morocco, yeah.
Because my mom is African and my father is Spanish. I was born in Spain because of the communication that have Africa with Spain.
Mm-hmm.
So my mix, you can see in Spain a lot of mix like me, like Spain with Spanish with African. People, they always think that I'm Dominican. If I don't speak, when I speak,
I know.
They don't know from where I am.
So, because this is my first time, this is, well, you know, I've talked to you on the phone, but this is our first long conversation. I thought you was Dominican.
Oh, you were? You were thinking, right?
I completely thought you was Dominican.
I know, always. Until I open my mouth and they say, no, she's not Dominican.
Yeah, because so I thought you was Dominican, and then I talked to you on the phone, and I noticed the accent. Mm-hmm. And I was like, yeah, she's not Dominican.
She's not Dominican, but I don't know from where is she.
Do you have you been in a magazine before?
No, not yet. But I'm working with Marin Nick.
Yeah.
The photographer, we are working on that. And I have already some, how I will say, some people that they want to feature me in the magazine.
Today, are you guys using, it's a website where models and photographers can get their work easily published. It's called caviar.com.
Oh, I didn't know. Caviar?
Yeah, caviar.com,
like,
yeah.
Like the food, caviar? The caviar?
No. It's caviar.com.
Okay.
It's Kavyar. Matter of fact, when we get off the phone,
caviar. Yes, it's coming. Write it down.
When we get off the phone, I will. I mean, I won't get off the phone. When we get off live, I will actually text it to you. Mm-hmm. I think it's the easiest way to get published. Like, you can get published in Elements. You can get published. You can get published in all the big independent magazines.
Mm-hmm.
And it's hundreds of us. So it's very, very easy to get published for anybody who uses that site. It's like the greatest site in the world to me, my opinion. I think it's the greatest. I think it's the greatest site when it for models and photographers and makeup artists and hairstylists. Because you can also use the site as a portfolio. You don't have to just use it for getting published. So if you don't have your own website and somebody wants to see your portfolio, you can also send them your profile because you have to create a profile on there.
Yeah, because in the profile, yeah, all the pictures are there. So when you asked me about if I was published in a magazine, today I was published in a magazine, but, I will find it and I will
Yeah, so as soon as we got off the phone, is I don't know if you have another computer around you or anything, but it's KAVYAR.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know.
Oh, with Y. Okay. Caviar with Y.
Yep. KAVYAR.
Mm-hmm. I see. So you like the pictures of my profile?
Yeah. I think you take good photos.
Mm?
I think you take good photos.
Thank you.
I just didn't know you. I knew nothing about you at all. All I knew was somebody sent me one of your photos.
Mm-hmm.
I followed you and I just watched.
Mm-hmm.
People do that all the time. People literally, models do it too. They'll send a photographer profile to me. They'll DM it. I'll follow and they'll follow, the photographer will follow me back. And then eventually I'll just DM the photographer and we'll start talking. Start picking each other's minds and stuff like that. So it's the same thing with models. When people send me models, that's not from where I'm at. I usually DM them, or we'll do like this stream right here. We'll do it privately, so it won't be live at all.
Mm-hmm.
It'll be taped, but when I put it on YouTube, it's cut into clips. And I do this. I don't do this as much as I used to do it during quarantine, but I do this. I try to do this throughout the week. Even if I'm only talking to somebody for 10 minutes, I still try to record it and stuff like that. I know a lot of people, I just got on an iPhone. So a lot of people like to do FaceTime. I'd rather just sit on my computer and pull my mic out mm-hmm. and do my whole little setup mm-hmm. and talk that way because the thing that I've learned is when you talk to people,
mm-hmm.
you guys have like people have a lot of information to share with each other and it can help other people. So like if me and you was having this conversation about you and modeling and how you got started in
mm-hmm.
agencies and advice, if me and you was talking about this in private compared to if we were talking about it in public, it's different because you may say experience or advice that may be able to help somebody.
Yeah, because they're I'm coming from another country, you know, struggling here, no English. So there is a lot of people, I'm sure, that they want to work like a model and they don't know how to start. They are lost, you know. So I think it's great when you can share with more people.
Yeah, I try to. I try to.
Let me show you here because today I was... let me see here. Publish. Do you see?
Yeah. What page is that?
It's my New York magazine.
All right. Let's see. Is it is my _?
Yes.
New York
magazine.
Oh, yeah. I see you on there.
Yeah. This is my first. It's good. I'm happy. So yes, I just I sent the woman that runs the magazine. She contacted me through Instagram.
Yeah.
And yeah, I just sent some pictures. I sent a description of me, and I was featured there, so more people can follow me, can see my work, and yeah. I'm happy that people like my work, because I'm doing this not only for me, for the people too, you know. For me, yeah. This is art. All these pictures are art for me.
Yeah,
so I try to do, even when I have a photo shoot that is lingerie or is a swimsuit, I always try to be sexy, but in the same time, like, not too much. Like being that model, you know,
myself. Yeah, the photographer that you shoot with.
There is a very thin. Sorry to interrupt you. There is a very thin line to go to when you are like, I can say that I'm kind of sexy, you know. So there is a thin line to go to. How is this word? Yeah, when it doesn't look elegant and looks the other way. So I try to create my profile like good, not too much.
Yeah, the guys that you shoot with, they got some good work. You know, when you shoot with good photographers, it definitely makes the model look way better.
Yes, way better. Mm-hmm. That's very important. Because the lighting, you know, it's very important. I have few photographers that they wrote me, but I decided to not work with them because I can see in their profile that it's not my style.
It's not your style? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I was featured too in Fresh Producer?
You said Fresh? A producer?
Yes. It's a design Fresh. This one?
Fresh?
He works with with a lot of artists like Chris Brown, Tyga, Tori Lanez. So he has an agency, model agency, and he told me if I want to work with him, and he just posted me to in his page.
All right, so you said it's Fresh. It's
D, like Diana. Yes, E-I-T, like tornado.
Oh, Fresh made it.
Mm-hmm. So if you go to his page, it's official Fresh Big Sense. That's the model agency.
Yep.
Yeah, and I'm there. So he works a lot, you know, with a lot of artists, and that's great because we will have a lot of work.
You met him through Instagram too?
So I met him because I have a good friend that he's in the music industry here in New York, like the big industry, and he just linked me with him.
Oh yeah, I see you on this page.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And now I'm trying about Bella Davis, the other she's model. Let me show you her because she's awesome. Bella Davis.
You said Bella?
I'm Bella Davis. She.
Okay, let's see.
So it's funny because one time I was in a photo shoot and one of the photographers told me, oh, you remind me to someone. And I say, who? And he told me, Bella Davis. I didn't know who was. So I started to follow her. And from Paul Tirado, are you seeing Bella Davis?
Yeah, I'm on her page now.
So she has a 48 entertainment. Is entertainment, yeah.
Yep, I see it, yep.
Yeah, it's the agency. It's her agency. I think she didn't start a long time ago with the agency. But she's great. She's a very good model. She give great jobs and yeah, it's legit. I can't wait to start working with her.
Is she from New York too?
She's Swedish and Jamaican. What a mix, right?
Yeah, she's Yeah. Oh, she's a model too.
Yeah, she's model. She is. Yeah. Mhm. She's great. So I'm about to start working with her soon. This is the photographer that Paul Tirado, he has great, the editing that he does is awesome. Paul Tirado.
Oh yeah, I see it, yeah.
Yeah, so he, we had the photo shoot like a few weeks ago, he texted Bella Davis and he was talking about me. So later she contacted me 1 week ago and she told me about if I want to work with her and yeah, send my portfolio. You know, everything is like this. It's about contacts. It's about you have a photo shoot with a photographer. You have good energy. You know, everything is good. Later that photographer can talk with someone and you start to just be a real model.
Yeah, everything is about, they say it's about who you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. In the beginning, you don't get paid sometimes, you know, because you have to...
You got to build yourself up.
To the people, so the people know you. But later, yeah, you should start to get paid. Because you are giving a service to people. So
right.
It has to be an exchange.
Yeah. As much as I tell models they need to start charging.
Yes.
You don't have to be modeling for 5 years to charge somebody.
You can always have even a conversation and have a deal and see what is good for both sides.
Yep, because if you don't actually get paid, nobody is going to pay you.
Exactly, yeah. Mm-hmm. That's true.
So, and I know a lot of, I don't know if I should say this, but I know a lot of photographers who get a lot of bookings off of shooting girls and they don't pay her at all.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Then when I say, hey, you need to start charging, I'm the bad guy for saying you need to start charging.
What happened? So we have to change them about what is money. Money is energy. Money, you know, money gives you freedom. There is nothing bad. Of course, you are giving a service. Imagine that someone is going, works in a supermarket and later is not getting paid. Never. So doesn't make sense. people that think like this, it's just people that they don't like to, you know, to give the value to other people because of their jobs.
Yeah, I don't know if I should say this on live, especially on Facebook. I have these conversations off live all the time.
Mm-hmm.
But if a photographer can shoot you over and over again for TFP or for free, he can pay you.
Mm-hmm.
So every time, Lord, this is gonna sound so bad. Any photographers that's watching this on Facebook and you disagree, and you take my apologies. But if you can shoot somebody over and over again for free, you could pay them. There's no such. I don't. Then again, I'm not a photographer, so I'm only speaking from somebody that's in modeling. But I'm not a photographer. I don't have a camera. I don't have a studio. But I do believe if you can shoot somebody over and over again for free, you can pay them. So when photographers say they don't pay models because all this stuff costs and all that cost, I understand that. But if you can shoot a popular model or a hot model and she brings you bookings, you can pay her.
Yeah. I have to say that I have like few photographers that they, like two photographers, three photographers that are like my main. EJ Creative, Paul Tirado, this Marine Nick photo. So we don't charge each other. We work together because we really create good material, and I'm trying to grow, you know, in the industry, and in the same time I can give to them good material about myself. So like this, I will never forget those people that they were helping me to grow in this industry, you know, in the moment that I will be up, that I wish I will do my best. So yeah, I don't have problem to not charging. So no,
yeah,
not have money from them, or because like that we help each other. But later, other people should start charging, because later they see in their page my pictures, and later they DM me and they ask me if I can be their muse. So if they can shoot me 2 days a week or something like this, or a month, and I think that, yeah, you should pay something.
Yeah. Any photographers who I'm friends with, and you guys watch this, don't text me afterwards and say I shouldn't have said that. My bad. It's y'all know how I feel about certain stuff. So any of my photographer friends, and y'all shoot people for free, and you don't agree that I think you can pay a model
if models you can keep shooting for free. Models too, paying photographers too. So
yeah. Speaking of that, yeah. Okay. So to get on the photographer side now, mm-hmm. models, it's okay to pay for photo shoots.
Mm-hmm.
I understand some models got this thing where it's like I don't pay for shoots, but it's like everybody. Mm-hmm. Top-notch guys ain't going for that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, I usually tell models, especially new models who are just beginning, I usually tell them to pay for their shoots. If you want the best quality work, pay for it.
Yes.
If you want the best quality work, pay for it. But, I mean, if you get it for free, get it for free. But if you pay for it, there's nothing wrong with paying for a shoot. There's only something wrong with paying for a shoot. And the only thing you know how to do with the photos is post them to Facebook. Then it's something wrong. But if you know how to do portfolios and comp cards and get published and use your photos to get you agreements with boutiques and designers, good. But if you're just taking photos, if you're just paying for your shoots just to post them on Facebook so you can, Lord.
No, I tried because not you are just spending, but you are not using your material. You are not, unless it's what you like, just show on Instagram yourself great pictures, but you have another job working in a hospital or something, I don't know, whatever. But yeah. No, if you are a model, that's your job.
And if you want to make modeling a career and something that you do forever, you're going to eventually have to pay for stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to have to pay for what you need. So it's nothing wrong with paying for a shoot. I understand people say they can't afford it, but it's a lot of stuff that we buy that we don't need.
It's when I talk about communication. Because if I was a photographer and maybe, you know, a model, I really like that model. I really want to work with that model and have material from her. So, and she can't pay me the amount that I'm asking for. Let's talk. Let's communicate and see, okay, what's your budget, you know, and we are humans. We can talk. We can, you know, it's easy. It's easier.
Yeah, I want to say maybe because I've been around for so long, but I don't know if it's that it's hard to make it. Now I can say it's hard to make it, yes, but it's not hard to get started in modeling.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to get started, it's not that hard. But I do absolutely feel and believe that it's absolutely hard to make it, yes,
because in this country, so there are a lot of girls like me, this color, my, you know, very similar, but finally nobody is like me, nobody is like you. It's about the personality, it's about, you know, who you are. So we are uniques. It's difficult, but how I told you, if you trust in your inner power, you can do it. If one person did it, I will say Naomi Campbell. Why I can't?
Yeah, if it's one person that came from the same situation as you who made it, anybody can make it. You know.
If one person went to the moon, we can go.
Yeah, for I do sure. believe that. Modeling can be frustrating. You know, it's good, it's ups and it's downs. It's all part of the journey. The one thing I don't like is models who just stop modeling. Like, you know, I stay in the area where it's four seasons. So in the summertime, everybody models. Then when it starts to get cold, everybody disappear.
Oh, yes.
And then they come back out when it get hot. And then they disappear when it get cold. And they come back out when it get hot. And then they disappear when it's cold.
But why they disappear when it's cold? Because they are at home or what?
I think a lot of models, I'm not quite sure why, because I think I'm a Lord, this is going to sound so bad. I'm going to talk to some models who I be feeling like disappear when it's cold. And I'm going to ask them, why do models disappear when it's cold?
It's funny.
When everybody comes out when it's hot. Everybody models when it's hot. When it's cold, they're nowhere to be found.
So how you eat during the winter if you don't work?
You know, at least where I'm at, we're not known for modeling. So a lot of people, majority of the models who model, they're not getting paid. They're not making any money.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of the photographers who are where I'm at, they're not, they have another job in order to afford to be able to do photography. I understand it. The only thing that sucks is Wisconsin is not known for modeling. That's what I'm saying. Like,
it's not known for modeling. You say
we're not known for modeling at all. Now, Chicago, which is an hour and a half away from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, they're absolutely known for modeling.
Mm-hmm.
But in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, we're not known for modeling
mm-hmm.
at all. There is no modeling market here. There is nothing here that
about the fashion industry, right?
Yeah, that's able to help a model absolutely get to that next level.
So that model has to travel.
So she's going to have to travel. She's going to have to use her Instagram. Where I'm located is good for building up your modeling, but it's not New York. This ain't New York. This ain't Chicago. This ain't Miami. This ain't LA. We're not known for modeling at all. So a lot of stuff that models here, like, I know in New York, it can cost like $400 just for headshots in New York. But if a photographer charged $150 for headshots in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, the model feel like it's too much. But it's like, if you go somewhere where modeling is known, you're actually getting a cheap price by getting it in where I'm at compared to shooting it, compared to Chicago and LA and New York. Our price for photo shoots is a blessing compared to where you at. So it's like, whatever the photographers are charging where you at, they couldn't live in Milwaukee and charge that price. Like, it's absolutely cheap compared to where you at, but the models here feel like it's too expensive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's too expensive.
So, that's the thing I don't like. It's the same thing with our fashion shows. Everybody wants to do fashion shows. There's nothing at none of these fashion shows that's beneficial to the models. Even our big fashion show ain't beneficial to models. Then again, I look at it like, as always, you can always make something out of nothing, right? So if our fashion shows here are not beneficial to models, then the models have to do a little bit more work.
Yes.
But if this was New York, or if this is LA, oh, it's different. You know, you can model in a small fashion show in New York and get way more than you can from a big show here.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that because we're just not known for modeling here.
That's true.
And that's the thing that sucks. So I'm trying to use my magazine to reach.
So in your magazine, there are different photographers.
Yeah, I have photographers from all over the world in my magazine.
Because you have great pictures.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
I'm on Instagram. I live on Instagram. I be on Facebook. Like, I'm a personal trainer. So I get on Facebook. I'll post some fitness videos. Other than that, I go right back to Instagram. I'm on Instagram.
Me too. I'm Instagram.
I live on Instagram. So what I've learned is, if I can't travel to the world, then I use Instagram. It allows me to be able to communicate and talk to people around the world. You know, especially my magazine, by me meeting so many different photographers and stuff and models, I'm able to talk to models and photographers and agencies and makeup artists that I would not have been able to talk to otherwise.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm trying to use my magazine to get me to the door, like trying to get me to the next level.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
No, I don't know if people think I'd be joking, but I don't plan on moving out of Wisconsin anytime soon. So, cause I feel like this is what my goal is. People that's watching this, for people that read my Facebook stories, they've heard me say this before, but my goal is to be the most valuable person to Wisconsin's modeling.
Mm-hmm.
right? Like I want to be
with the industry in Wisconsin.
I want to be that person.
You want to be the connection.
The connection, right? So when somebody thinks of Milwaukee or Wisconsin modeling, I want, if not me, I want my magazine to be in that conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So it's like, because you know, my daughter is five, so I always tell people, for the next 13 years, I'm stuck here.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
So I got 13 years to get myself as high as I can so that I can literally be able to do something major here. Because even when we have something that's major here, the people here treat it like it's nothing.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, okay, well, obviously I'm gonna have to do what I feel like I need to do to play my part. And hopefully when I get that opportunity to bring something big or do something big here, it's meaningful and it's viable. So
mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think my magazine and YouTube, specifically my magazine, is going to open up those opportunities for me. Cause I've been in modeling since '09. So
I have a question. The girls, yeah. The models that you shoot, let me charge my phone. Yeah. The models that you shoot, they are from Wisconsin. Wisconsin.
So
Wisconsin, right?
So everybody think I'm a photographer, right? I don't actually shoot models.
No, yes. So what you have in your magazine, those girls are from Wisconsin, right?
Usually in every magazine I have is one model from my state in it. Other than that, the rest of the models are around the world.
Mm-hmm.
I have models in my magazine that's from the state of Wisconsin that it seems like the state of Wisconsin don't know that model's from the state of Wisconsin.
Okay.
You know, so even though I stay in Milwaukee and Milwaukee is the largest city in Wisconsin, I can have a model from Racine in my magazine to Milwaukee is like, who is that? She's from the same state that you're from.
Mm-hmm.
So every magazine I come out with, or I ain't gonna say every, because I'll put out like 50 magazines, but more than half of the magazines I've put out with has had a model from Wisconsin in it. But it's like, by my magazine being all over the world, I'm just hoping to attract somebody from across the world where I can say, hey, we need help, can you help us? And they say, yeah, I can help you, this is how I can help, and they come to Wisconsin and help.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like I don't plan on leaving until I accomplish my ultimate goal, which is to be the most viable person ever. Ever.
Yeah,
I want to be like the Michael Jordan, LeBron James of modeling here.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So, because I've always told people, if I move away, I might not come back. And to be honest, because I tell people that's just me being honest. You know, a lot of people, they don't succeed in their hometown, so they move away. And then I tell people, until I succeed in my hometown, I'm not moving away.
Mm-hmm.
So I got 13 years. When my daughter turned 18, I will sit down and decide, should I move away? But until then, I got 13 more years to literally become the most influential, most viable person in the state of Wisconsin when it comes to modeling. And I think my magazine is going to help me get there.
You will do it, for sure.
I know. I don't think about it too much. Like, I just work and put out content, but...
Yeah, but that's happen. Your focus.
Yeah, it's going to happen. I'm not...
We have a lot of power, so if you want to do something and you just put all the energy in that and visualize, Okay. So I will give two advices from
okay, I'm listening.
Angle, okay?
Yep.
That I didn't say before. One of them for the models and even photographers, because I realized something in some profiles of great photographers that seriously, their jobs are amazing, but they don't put hashtags, even models too. So later they don't have too much followers, they don't have too much likes when they really do great job in the editing and everything. So you should put the 30 hashtags that Instagram is.
Yeah, Instagram allows.
Because like that you will have more, how you say, view? Like you will be in more page, you know? So more people, you will reach to more people, and you never know who is there, how you say before. You never know who can see you and maybe wants you to work in their brand, you know, or commercials or whatever. So use hashtags and visualize. So I'm a spiritual person, and I really believe in the we are energy, right? So I really believe in the power of write your goals, and every morning, every night when you wake up, just read that, you know, and finally that will be your reality, and you will become what you really want to be. So I was doing that with someone. I went to Amazon, I bought a board, and I put a big board, and I put in my wall, and I was writing all the goals that I want to achieve. And I can say that it's happening. So trust in yourself. That's the most important, the most powerful. Doesn't matter what people say, doesn't matter. You just be in touch with yourself.
Yep. So I do want to say, anytime you do a photo shoot and you need the photos published, let me know.
Okay.
Any magazine of mine that you're in, whether you're on the cover or you're inside the magazine, I'll mail it to you. So I do that for all the models who went live with me. They all have this. If you're ever in my magazine, whether you're in the cover or whether you're on the cover or you're inside, I will mail you that issue of the magazine. Because this is just, like, especially for my YouTube, this is the beginning. I'm gonna build my YouTube up to be a force too, but everybody who contributed or helped me at my beginning, I don't forget. So it's like, for the models who helped me build up all this stream and this EVON TV.
I'm the same.
Yeah, all the models that helped me build it up, I owe them. So it's like the one way that I can repay them at the current moment is any magazine of mine that they're ever in, I'll send it to them. Now you're gonna have to remind me.
Of course, you have a lot of jobs.
Yeah, it's gonna get to a point where it's like I done told like 50 models and I'm gonna forget. But usually, if you know, I can always just go back and look over my YouTube. Of the models that said, hey, you said you're gonna mail me the magazine if I'm in it. I could just go to my YouTube and see. But yeah, if you ever have anything that you need published, you can text me or you can DM me and let me know. I'll check it out.
I will. Joe.
If it works for the cover, I'll let you know.
Yes.
I already have the cover. If you, especially if you send me photos during a time where the magazine is almost done, but I'm just waiting to release it. Mm-hmm. I'll let you know that I won't be able to use them for the cover. But if you send me something early, or you send me something and it gives me an idea of a issue theme, then I'll use it for the cover. I'll send it to you for free as a thank you for contributing to my growth of my EVON TV.
You are contributing. This world is difficult, seriously. You are contributing with my growth too. So I'm really grateful. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity of to show you myself, are. You know?
Yep. It's pretty soon. Yeah.
You have 2 Instagrams.
I have 10 Instagrams.
Huh?
I got 10 Instagrams.
Mamma mia, 10?
Okay, so I got a personal Instagram. I got a model team Instagram. I got EVON TV.
Mm-hmm.
I got 6 magazines. I got 6 different magazines.
That's true.
And then I have a fitness Instagram. So I got 10 Instagrams.
Oh, fitness because a personal trainer.
Personal trainer, yeah. So I got a lot of Instagrams. That's the reason why I'm on Instagram way more than Facebook.
Yeah, now I understand. If you have 10.
Yeah, so since I got 6 magazines, I have to be on those Instagrams every day throughout the day. Because on my EVON magazine, I post on that Instagram throughout the day.
Mm-hmm.
So in my EVON Bold, I post on that throughout the day too. But that's the reason why, like, you know, now that we Facebook friends, you'll probably see I rarely ever post any stats.
Mm-hmm.
If anything, I'll post a workout video and that's it.
Mm-hmm.
I'll post a story and that's it. I go right back to Instagram. Because I have to be on Instagram because it's like that's where all my income comes from.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So, I got a lot of Instagrams. I got a lot. And it's hard to build all of them up, but my EVON magazine, my EVON magazine is helping build up all my other Instagrams.
That's very good. Mm-hmm.
How many Instagrams do you have?
Instagrams?
Yeah.
No, just
one. You just got one?
Before I had 2 or 3, but no, it's too much. I just want to focus in. Yeah, no, because I understand for you. I understand because you have 6 magazines. You are a personal trainer too, you know, so it's different. But for me, I just need one. And I post everything there. So people can reach me there.
Are you, you have a YouTube?
No. YouTube channel?
Yeah.
No. I understand for you. I understand.
Okay.
I didn't think even about that. You know, once I will start with this agency and everything will change in my career. So...
Wait. You say you want to start a modeling agency?
Oh, no, yes. I will start with Bella Davis.
Oh, you want to start with her? Okay. I thought you were talking about you want to start your own.
Yes. No. So once that will be the...
Yeah. Matter of fact, All right, so I'm not going to forget that I said this, but you might forget. But,
Can you say again?
I said, I'm not going to forget what I'm about to say. I'm not going to forget, but you might forget. So when you get signed, 6 months after you sign, we should do this again.
Okay.
Because I want to know. I want to know how the experience went.
Yeah. Makes sense.
Yeah, so... Hold on. Matter of fact, I'm gonna follow that modeling agency that you
Yes. With Bella, right? Another thing I was doing, I was going to maybe the Instagram of big models, you know, and I was trying to have connection with designers and follow them, you know, like some pictures, put some comment. So like that, you know, if they like me, they can go to my Instagram. It's like knock, you know, hey, I'm here. Because if you don't do that, it's difficult, like, that the people can see you. Because, yeah, there is a lot of people on Instagram. And to grow your account, you need to do that too. Even I messaged some designers, you know, they respond to me. They told me that when everything, like, will be normal, they would love to, like, to work with me, you know, like wear their customs and, yeah, their clothes. So I think that that's very important to try to cut those people, because it's the people that you need to grow for your growth. I have to tell you that, like, three weeks ago, I had like 4,400 followers. 1 month ago.
You talking about on Instagram?
Three weeks ago, on Instagram. And now I have almost 5,500. So I'm really trying my best. Always when I go to an event, you know, that there are models, I always take Instagrams, you know, it should be like this. So people can follow your work, or if they need a model sometime, they can contact you. Yeah, you should ask for Instagrams of other people.
What's the, how do you spell the agency that you may be getting signed to?
Oh, 48 Entertainment.
Oh, that's who you may, that's who you may end up getting signed to?
Oh, yeah, that's the Bella Davis.
Okay, yeah, I follow them. Mm-hmm. Okay. I got notes that I keep in my mm-hmm. tablet, so I'm writing them down so that when I get off, mm-hmm. I can
yes.
put them on my tablet. So
you have that photographer EJ Creative too, right?
You say EJ Creative?
Yes. His job is beautiful.
You said okay, hold on.
EJ Creative.
EJ Creative?
Yes, Nick.
Okay, EJ
Creative, Nick.
Oh, Creative. Yeah, I see it. Yeah. Yeah, I got it.
Yeah, his editing is really good too. With him, he told me if I wanted to work in his idea about this web series for YouTube, that are like some episodes, you know, will be like comedy. And yeah, and I just did the first episode with him. Very good.
All right, so I want to do a quick... We're gonna do a short commercial because I need you to go give me some water.
Mm-hmm.
And I would hate to do it while on live. I hate to do it on live and they just see me walk away from the camera and you just sitting here. Mm-hmm. So what I'm gonna do is, I think I got this figured out, but I'm gonna play a video as a commercial. And we will come back as soon as the video is done playing. So it is about, this video is 2 minutes and 39 seconds. So we will come back in about 2 minutes. Hold on, let me get this set up so the transition is smooth.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Okay, I got it. Yeah, so I'm gonna play a video. We gonna take a 2 minute and 40 second break because mm-hmm. I need to put some ice in my cup.
Okay. What are you drinking?
I drink water.
Okay.
I mean, being a trainer, I cannot be on live eating and drinking bad.
No.
So.
Well, you were drinking, I don't know, soda.
Nah. I mean, soon as I get off live, I'm going to drink me some soda, yeah.
No soda. Personal trainer, no soda.
What's wrong with soda?
No soda.
You don't drink soda?
No, I try to not. Too much sugar and too much gas.
Yeah. So, everybody that's watching on YouTube, especially for y'all that's on YouTube, because I've been ignoring the viewers on YouTube. My bad. For those who are on YouTube and those who are on Facebook, we are going to take a 2 minute, 2 minute 40 second break. We gonna come back. We'll probably talk about 5 or 10 more minutes. Then I'm gonna let her go and, everybody that's watching, I hope you enjoy your night. So give us 2 minutes, 40 seconds. I'll probably be back in 2 minutes so that I can pop back into the screen as soon as the video is done playing. We'll talk about 5 or 10 minutes, and then I will let you go so I ain't got to hold you up.
Okay.
All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take us both out.
I'm going to put the video in.
Got something else to say. I'm fresh wolf gray. Yeah, you know my shoes sway. Hey, propane, better stay out my lane. I keep it real smooth, you can call it wood grain. Tryna get a ring when I step in the game. My hook like a rain, Abdul in the pain. Vince Carter, East Bay, better yet, MJ. From the corner like Ray, go with Kobe, King James. Robbie Horray, last shot in your face. I'm magic on the plague in my flow, word they. In my Penny Hardaway, or Chuck, Dr. J. Just staying out the way, so you know I can't complain. Hey, trying to get some change, turn a penny to a range. And when you hit it, know it's C. Hayes.
Gotta do it. Like, am I pulling?
All right.
That model is beautiful.
Yeah, that's it's a model named Bernice that's in my modeling team. So when I went to break, I checked my text messages. This whole time, I did not know my background was that dark. somebody sent me, I got a text message. It was like, hey, you know it's dark outside. You need to raise the light up in your in your background. I had no idea I was starting to fade into my background that bad. So thank you for the person that texted me. Cause I didn't realize my background was not that lit. Cause when what I see, it looks bright on my end.
Yeah.
So in the video, it was like, cause you know, I started recording when it was daytime. We went live when it was daytime.
Exactly. Here. Yeah.
And it got dark. And,
me too.
I hope they can see me. Like, hey, huh?
I hope they can see me good.
You're fine. Fine. It's just that my background was starting to, I was starting to fade in. Yeah, my background was dark, so I was starting to fade into my background.
Mm-hmm.
So let's see. Let's make sure YouTube is still watching.
Yes.
YouTube is still watching.
Make sure the people from YouTube.
Everybody. Matter of fact, I got 100% like ratio on YouTube, so I need y'all to share the video. But is it anything? Because I didn't even realize it was this late. Last time I looked at the clock, it said 7:15. It's 8:15 now.
It's 8:15?
Well, there? Where I'm at is 8:15.
So here is 9:15. Yeah.
Yep. So is it anything? Speaking of that, if it's anything you want to talk about and you ever want to do this again, just text me.
Yes.
Next time we do it, it doesn't necessarily have to be planned or scheduled. Like you can text me or call me on the fly and be like, you want to talk about something? And we can just go live.
You know, now that everything will start to change and I will have like more projects and I will let you know, because I really, it's what you say, I really want to share with people that they are lost. They don't know. If I'm doing, they can do it too. Seriously.
Yeah. So yeah, I always try to make sure that the first time I go live with somebody is scheduled and it's thought out and it's planned.
Yeah.
But all the other times it's like, even if it's 5 minutes, because I tell the other models, I'll be like, hey, if you want to call me about something, video chat me. But if it's something about modeling or something that you want to share, let's share like this. Even if it's 5 minutes.
To the help people.
You know, yeah, because it may be able to help people.
Mm-hmm.
So I just want you to.
And you really enjoy it too. To be with the microphone, you know. You really enjoy it too. That.
Yeah. Pretty soon. See, okay, so because I've been slow on doing stuff, I can actually do a live call-in show, right? So I can do a live call-in show. Next month, I'm going to start doing this inside of a studio.
Okay.
And then in April, most likely in April, I'm going to do this in a whole, hopefully a actual production.
Wow. So, this year looks good.
Right now, I could actually, on my second computer that I have right here and through my other phone, I can actually do a live call-in show.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't want to do it because I don't want to be sitting here answering phones. I thought it was going to be fun to do.
You don't want what?
I don't want to just be answering calls, just be answering right now.
Okay.
Right? Because I thought it was going to be fun to do.
But
and
no.
Then I did. I went live one time. It wasn't on Facebook. It was only on YouTube. And the phone calls I was getting, it was like, oh, that's how live call-in shows go. You got to, because you got to filter the calls. Right? Because you got to make sure that people that are calling, whatever they want to say, it makes sense towards the stream.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have anybody else helping me do all this. So it's like I had nobody to filter the call. So I went live with a model probably about a month or so ago. She had a YouTube channel. So I was her guest on her YouTube channel, but I had my live call-in show connected, and the call-ins was not. It wasn't modeling related. It was a lot of personal questions that people was asking her.
And it's like questions?
Yeah. You know how guys can be?
Yeah.
Yeah. So it was like, oh, I need somebody to filter through my calls. So I can do a live call-in show. I have everything set up. I just can't run that by myself. So I'm at least need one other person that people won't see in the stream. I need them right here on my other computer, right here, filtering calls.
So you can do a comedy show?
No, like a call-in show where people can call in. Yeah. So instead of commenting on the video, people can call in and ask questions.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No, I have the whole setup for that.
That's crazy. That's
So yeah, next month I will be in a studio doing this. And then in April, hopefully I can do a actual production where I have multiple cameras and all that stuff. I want to be able to do this face-to-face, but obviously I can't do it face-to-face with people that don't stay here.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think I'm going to do it face-to-face unless I do me and my friends, we just sit and we just talk about modeling stuff. But when I talk to models, like I'm talking with you, this is not nothing that I can do face to face. So this will have to stay over video. But I got everything that I got this whole thing planned out. You know, so I think the city where I'm at, the city may be closing down soon. So that's gonna give me perfect time to literally do this, because then I ain't gotta worry about getting up going to the gym.
That's great.
So, yeah, next time we talk.
It's about time too.
Yeah, next time we talk, you'll see.
The difference.
Matter of fact, next time me and you talk like this, I'll be in the studio. But
yes.
Over the months, you'll start
it's
to
more
see that.
Light, right?
Yeah, it'll be more light. It'll be a drop down mic, because I actually want a mic that drops down. I don't like this mic that sits right here.
Mm-hmm.
And I won't be at home either.
I know, yeah. Because that's your house, right?
Yeah, it's my house.
Okay.
So I'm going to start doing this in the studio with lights and cameras and colors going on in the background. Because I have I was going to make my apartment into a YouTube studio. And then it's like, I don't want to stay in this apartment for long.
Mm-hmm.
Or I should at least wait until I move into a newer apartment and then make one of my rooms into a YouTube studio.
Yeah, create that room like a studio.
So, yeah, if it's any closing words from you or that you want to say.
So, yeah, I think I said everything. I didn't even know that I could speak in English like this in an interview live, that I know that all the people are watching me, you know, and yeah, it's sometimes when I don't know a word, I'm like, but everything was very organic, was fluent, and I really had a great time. I even learned some things about me talking with you and with all the people that are watching us. So that's great. I really appreciate this opportunity that you gave to me, and this won't be the last time that we will talk.
Yeah. I got your number, you got my number, so yeah, we'll talk again. I didn't pop any of the questions up on the stream because I'm getting questions from all over the place.
Oh, yes.
So next time we do this, even
that's
if we do
good. That means that people are watching, people are, you know.
Yeah, next time we do this, even if we do it for five, even if it's a 5-minute thing that we do this, I will make sure to pop the comments onto the screen.
Yeah.
Because I'm not going to be able to read all the comments from all the pages that I shared this on. But for those who did watch, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Jim Clark, he commented, I must have missed his comment. He said, good to see you all.
Oh.
And he said, sharing your journey helps others.
Yes, of course.
So for those who are watching on Facebook, right now, if I go to my group page, because I got like 6 groups, all EVON something. If I add up all the numbers,
I don't know how you don't go crazy. You don't go crazy with 10 Instagrams, 6 in Facebook.
Yeah, before I got into modeling, I was a music artist. So a lot of music artists, they have to sit on social media and share they songs and all that stuff all over the place. It's just natural for me to be able to run multiple pages and not feel overwhelmed.
What were you doing in the music industry?
I used to rap.
Okay.
I used to make the music that I would not let my daughter listen to at the age of 5. I wouldn't let my daughter listen to my music. The song, my daughter, it's this WAP song by, who's singing that song? Oh, Cardi B and Megan Thee Stallion.
Mm-hmm.
It's called WAP.
Yeah, I know.
It's a vulgar song. She sings it. She be behind me on the couch singing it. And it's funny. Like, I'm not mad because it's funny because I let my daughter use TikTok, right? You know, TikTok originally was a lot of kids for adults. So I let my daughter make TikTok videos. So she still does it. And that's one of the songs that when she's strolling through other people's TikToks is always playing. And she'll be sitting right behind me singing it. And it makes me sad, but it's funny.
Yeah.
I remember when I was a little kid, mommy didn't want me listening to certain songs. I used to sneak and listen to it. And it's like now having a kid, it's like, man, the songs nowadays is so bad. You know, it's
maybe some words.
Yeah, it's certain words where it's like, man.
Yeah, because you know Cardi B, her songs, some words are not for kids.
Yeah, her words
are not even for me. Are not even for me. Seriously.
Yeah. I've never heard the song fully, but it's my daughter be singing the song and it makes me sad, but it's funny at the same time.
In the same time, yeah, hearing her with 5 years old singing, right?
Yeah. So we have been live for 2 hours. Everybody that's watching on YouTube, thank you for continuing.
We were 2 hours.
We are at 2 hours and
wow, this was like this.
We had 2 hours and 3 minutes.
Okay.
So yeah, for those who are on YouTube watching, thank you. For the 17 people who are watching be on my group page, thank you. We will be doing this again.
Yes.
Even
Instagram, please.
Yeah. On YouTube, Instagram is in the link in the bio. People that's watching on Facebook, her Instagram, it should have been in the caption, but I will put it in the caption of the video right now.
Thank you.
It's also in the comment section too.
Okay.
It's in the comment section, but I will put it I'm gonna put it in the caption right now because I know a lot of people tend to watch the videos late.
Yes.
So let me copy this, add this to the caption of the video.
So I live in Bushwick. I don't know if you know. It's in Brooklyn.
Yeah.
And we have a studio here, like 5 minutes away. And there are a lot of artists that they rap, you know, and they come here. And I'm about to go there now when we finish, because there is a big producer that is there with some friends.
Yeah.
It's very good to have those contacts, you know, music videos, if they need a model. So girls, like, this is how you have to do. Just catch all the opportunities.
Yeah, catch all the opportunities while you can.
Exactly.
Are you going to be taking videos and photos?
Yes.
Are you there? Yeah. So I'll be paying attention to Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, I might go live on Instagram just for 5 minutes. I think I'm going to go live on Instagram when I get off. Yeah, I'm going to put my headset on and I'm going to go live on Instagram and talk to them for 5 minutes. But
What'd
you say?
Can I ask you something? How you did?
I'll be 35 and I'll be 35 on October 26th.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So sometimes I feel like I'm old. Because I work out, I feel young, but I feel old in age.
No, I think from 30 is a great age.
Yeah, I think 30 is
because you already know. Some people know, of course, they don't know, but you already know who you are and what you want to do, so that's great.
Yeah.
With 20s, you're still...
You're having fun in your 20s. Yeah, life is different when you're in your 30s.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I'm gonna pay attention to your stories, if you're posting your stories throughout the night. I'm about to go live on Instagram and talk to them for like 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, whenever you want to do this again, just text me.
Okay.
We can do this again. If you want to, whether it's long or short, we can do it.
Okay.
If you just want to catch up, we can do it. It don't matter. We can talk about what's going on in the world right now.
Yes.
Politics. I don't know nothing about politics.
Let's have content, you know, so people, they are not bored and they can.
Yeah. We're going to have something to talk about because just not politics, because I don't know nothing about politics.
We entertain people.
Yes. Yeah, we do entertainment. So
mm-hmm.
I will text you when I get off. Other than that, thank you guys for everybody who's watching.
Thanks to all of you. Thank you so much, people.
And for those who are on YouTube, thank you for watching. Facebook, thank you for watching. I'm about to go live on Instagram, EVON Magazine on Instagram. You can follow her. Her link is in the caption of Facebook, is in the description of YouTube. And we will see you guys later. Everyone have a good night. All right, so I'll talk to you soon.
Okay, have a good night, people.
See you.
See you.